asking the divine presence of our beloved Lord and offering our million salutations at his lotus feet, and also acknowledging Swami's presence in the hearts and the minds of each of everyone who is assembled here. Our most loving pranams to all of you, revered elders, dear brothers and sisters, a very warm and loving Sai Ram to all of you. This is a great privilege. In fact, we have to pinch ourselves for a moment to acknowledge the presence that we are currently in, which is the hallowed halls of Sundaram. In fact, in many ways, Sundaram is a part of Bhagwan's life, because his autobiography is also called Satyam, Shivam and Sundaram. So many, many memories pass by in our minds when we just think of Swami and the beautiful darshan that Bhagwan was giving us even to this day. How lucky we are that this is one avatar who has been captured by technology, right? Probably the only avatar whose every mood has been captured in a frame or in a video reel. So many, many grateful pranams to Swami to have allowed this to happen. And in fact, when we were, you know, when we were invited over here, when we were called here, the mind was dilly-dallying between two things. One is, we want to come to Sundaram. More than you wanting to come over here, we want to come over here. Because the kind of rich legacy and tradition that is there in Sundaram is worldwide. It's known worldwide. And many, many thanks goes to the Sundaram Bhajan group for being the kind of force it has been in Sai Bhajans all across the world. In many ways, to a large extent, I would say that Sai Bhajans is what it is around the world because of the Sundaram Bhajan group. In fact, way back in the 60s, it was the Sundaram Bhajans that, you know, went around the world. The cassettes of the Sundaram Bhajans were looked forward to more than Bahubali and all of those other kind of, you know. Everybody was looking forward, when is the next Sundaram Bhajans going to come? That pretty much set the stage for Sai Bhajans to proliferate around the world. So we are in that place, and so we were very, very kind of excited to be here. But then the other thought was, and if that group is already over here, then what are we doing here?
We are still wondering actually what we are doing here when we have all of them sitting here.
Exactly. So it is a little intimidating to be sitting in the presence of the Sundaram Bhajan group and trying to tell about bhajans. So we can only say that we are not here exactly as Brother Ramchandran said. We are here just to share Swami's love. And the only qualification we have is that we love bhajans as much as you all do. And the only other qualification, in fact, you know, I'm very quickly reminded of a very beautiful chinnakatha that Swami used to say, and I'll start off with this. It seems there was a very great sculptor, you know, and he used to do exquisite work with statues. Every statue that he made was so real that people, you know, from far and wide would just come to see the statue. So one day, you know, the king of the land comes over there and he says, why don't you make a Vishnu statue for me? You know, I want to keep it in my bedroom in the royal palace. And so he works hard and he makes the most beautiful Vishnu idol, you know, that can be made. Now he has to transport it to the kingdom, isn't it? So the only means of transport for him was his donkey, right? So he loads this beautiful statue of Vishnu on the back of the donkey. And the donkey starts moving through the crowd. Now, seeing the statue, all the devotees, you know, such a beautiful, almost like real, all the people on the road, all the, you know, citizens of the city, they come and they start, you know, paying obeisance to the statue. And this donkey starts to believe that all of them are paying respects to him. Because, you know, in his mind, Swami is telling, the donkey starts saying, Appa, finally people are acknowledging my work. These many years I have slogged out. Finally, you know, I'm getting the due for what all I have done. Okay, and people are throwing chandan and kumkum and flowers. And, you know, he's bathing in that and he's thinking, ah, you know, oh Lord, finally you have listened to me. Now they know what is my worth. You know, and the donkey is royally brought to the palace. And the statue is taken off the back of the donkey. And then the donkey is told, get out from here now. Okay, go back to your place. And now when the donkey is coming back, going back home, nobody bothers about him. And Swami says the donkey is wondering, see, what is this world, I say? You know, just 5 minutes back, I was being celebrated, I was being anointed, I was being propitiated. And today, here I am, you know, going back and nobody bothers about me. Such is the world. And Swami says, you students are like that, like that donkey. As long as I am seated in your heart and I am seated in your head, the world will pay respects to you. The day Swami gets out of your head and your heart, the world doesn't bother about you. So all of your love that we see over here is truly your love for Swami that is making you all come here. And all of those accolades and all, we are not going to become donkeys. Brother Ramchandran, for all that introduction that you gave, we are not going to become donkeys, Swami. We don't want to become those donkeys. We know what is our worth. So all of these accolades and everything, even the brickbats and everything, let us offer at His divine lotus feet. And let us start this satsang. So to begin with, I'll request all of us to close our eyes. Okay, before you close your eyes, one more thing. Keep your back straight as possible. Be relaxed, but don't strain your back. Just be relaxed. You know, Swami would often say, before you close your eyes, Swami would often say, you know, He says, if your back is like this, if it's not like this, if it is like this, no? Later on in your life, your whole life will become a question mark. What am I doing here? What did I do? Because our backs are like this, no? So later on in life, when we become 60 and we become fully like this, then question marks will come. Swami said, don't let your life be a question mark. Let it be an exclamation mark. Oh, what a life. So let us be relaxed. Let's close our eyes. Breathe normally. And as we do this, let us picturize a cloth in front of us. And whatever we have achieved in our life, let us put it in that cloth. Our degrees, our positions, our status, our name, our fame, our nationality, our caste, everything we are putting into this cloth. Now let us tie this cloth tightly and let us keep it aside. Now we have no name. Now we have no status, position, pride. Everything is packed and kept in that. Let us picturize ourselves sitting on the banks of a lake. A placid lake, a still lake. And as we see the lake, in the middle of the lake, there is a beautiful lotus. And in that lotus, we see our Lord Narayana sleeping. A beautiful smile adorns his face. And seeing his face, we also have a smile on our lips. And our heart sings.
Narayana Hari Narayana Bhajanarayana Sai Narayana
Narayana Hari Narayana Bhajanarayana Sai Narayana
Narayana Hari Narayana Sai Narayana
Narayana Hari Narayana 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 Jaya Narayana Sai
So, if I may disturb you, how do you feel right now? At this moment, right at this moment, is there any problem in our life? Is there any thought in our life? What do you feel right now, at this moment? Happiness? Peacefulness? Is there any acknowledgement even of the peace? You are just there, isn't it? In fact, there is no, even that happiness is not like a celebration. It's just you are there, right? See, this is not something that, the reason why we wanted to do this is not something which is there only in the Upanishads. This is the Sachidananda that you are experiencing right now. The only difference between the Sachidananda that the Upanishads and all talk about and Swami talks about is that that is a constant integrated awareness. What we are having right now is periodic integrated awareness. Now, temporary integrated awareness. Right now, there is no issue in our life. There is no problem. Suddenly, another 2 minutes, another call comes, another SMS comes, another WhatsApp comes, and all of the world gets reloaded into our heads. No? All our problems come flooding back to us. But that is exactly what Swami is trying to tell us, that no, this is your truth. This is who you are. When Swami says, being, awareness, bliss, Atma, Baba, this Baba, Satchit, Ananda, Swarupa, this is who you are. Right now, whom we are, what we experienced is Swami. Where there is no problems. Do you agree with me? Do you you want to challenge? No problem. I'm throwing open a challenge. Right now, when you just finished this visualization process, what was going on in your mind? Let's ask some small children here. Some of you slept off, I think. Sunday morning, nice hall. How many of you slept off? Because sleeping is again, you know, sushupti, no? It is deep sleep, it is. So this stillness of the mind is the purpose of bhajans. Unfortunately, for we singers, in the bhajans only we become maximum restless. Oh God, what is the next line? What is the next word? Shruti, will he put properly? Will tabla play properly? No? Bhajans, which are supposed to be a source of stillness of the mind, is now becoming the reason for our restlessness. This is not the purpose for which Swami gave us Sai Bhajans, isn't it? So the purpose of every sadhana is to achieve the stillness of the mind. Do we agree? Yes? All of us? Because once we take up this as our starting point, that whatever I do in the Sathya Sai organization, in the name of Swami, must achieve only one thing, and that is stillness and purity of the mind. We are not here for anything else. We are not here to showcase our talents. We are here only to offer our talents to Bhagwan. We are not here to showcase our talents, right? Because all of that will only lead to restlessness of the mind. For a moment, no, let me assume that I showcase my talent. What if nobody sees it? I think I have sung very well, so I have showcased my talent. And nobody comes and pats me on the back. Nobody says, "Arey, tum acha, you know, you sang nalla paading ringe." Pardon my Tamil. Right? Nobody says anything. Then what happens to us? Ayyo, did I sing well? No, doubt starts to creep in. Restlessness is there. That's not the purpose of Sai Bhajans, at least. So today, we will focus on how Sai Bhajans must become the source of the stillness of our minds. So in fact, all of you are bhajan singers. The collective stillness that must be right now in Sundaram must be at an all-time high, isn't it? Correct. We are all singers. We are all Sai Bhajan singers. Which means right now, the collective Satchidananda in this room must be at least above the average Chennai Satchidananda, isn't it? This is the max. We are all the maximum carriers of Satchidananda. Yes or no? Yes. Confidently, yes. Yes,
that is what it is supposed to be, at least. No? Very beautifully, the last time when I met Balram Chandra after a similar workshop, he said something very beautiful, and that is what is constantly running on my mind. So irrespective of which side of the stage you are sitting, we just happen to sit on this side of the stage, you could as well be sitting there, it is that this kind of bhajan workshop or anything that we take up as a sadhana is aspirational. That is such a beautiful word, because we are all trying to become something. So this stillness of the mind, as Amay was saying, if we all achieve it all the time, then we have no need to be here.
We don't need bhajans.
We don't need bhajans. We don't need anything. Yeah. We have examples of great bhajan singers who have gone beyond singing bhajans. You know, because they said even that is not necessary. Even that is coming in between them and Swami. You know, so that is the ultimate you know, aspiration that we get as bhajan singers.
As even once again what Brother Ramchandran said, no, it's not the singing but the silence in between the singing that is more. So we are all aspiring to achieve that silence.